Good morning, children. We start our lesson. Okay. So till what we have started? Scoring we have. Means scoring is what? Scoring is nothing but the wash. Okay. We have to wash the fleece. Okay. Wash the fleece and then bleach it and then color it. Okay. So these are the process we are doing in the scoring. Okay. And to remove the dust, everything we are doing in this scoring, everything we are, what we are doing, we are washing and cleaning and we are removing all the dust from the fleece. Okay, so this process is known as scoring or washing. So after washing, what they do, they pass the air into the fleece. Why they are passing the air into the cool air into the fleece or the fur? To make them soft. Okay. After that, after taking all this fleece and when they are dry, they keep in a heap. కుప్పలాగా పెట్టేస్తారు అన్నమాట. ఓకే, దే కీప్ ఇన్ ఏ హీప్స్. ఓకే, దే కలెక్ట్ ఆల్ దిస్ ఫ్లీస్ అండ్ దే కీప్ ఇట్ ఇన్ ద హీప్స్. ఓకే, గుంప గుంపలాగా పెట్టేస్తారు అన్నమాట. అండ్ ఆఫ్టర్ దట్ దే సపరేట్ దెమ్. దే విల్ సపరేట్ దిస్ షార్ట్ హెయిర్. దే సపరేట్ ద, వాట్ దే డూ, దే సపరేట్ ద లాంగ్ హెయిర్. ఓకే, లాంగ్ హెయిర్, షార్ట్ హెయిర్, short hair and also smooth hair, like this. They separate all this hair into a different in the long hair. They separate the one group. Okay, like this they separate the fleece. Unwanted material like bits of fleece etc. may be present with the wool and also separated out. Okay, along with this they contain the twigs, means small stem they present, or sometimes the leaves of the plants they contain on in the heaps or the in the fleece. Okay, so they also separate this twigs and the leaves, dry leaves, from the fleece or the fur. This process is called sorting. This process is known as when they are separating the hair. When they are separating the hair, so and also they are separating the unwanted material from the fleece. This process is known as sorting. Okay, sorting. Now, this process is called sorting or the wool classing. Fleece is the soft mass of wool. Okay, fleece is nothing but the soft. Now it becomes the soft. It is a soft material. The wool is now soft. How do these woolen fibers get different colors? How they are getting the different color to the wool? We can see this wool are in a different color. We can see. How they are able to do this coloring to the wool? So they keep this. They have a different color tubs. They have a different color tubs. Okay, so first they take the fleece or the wool, or the fur we can say, or the hair you can say. Okay, so we can take this and we are bleaching this. We bleach them by using the chemical. What happened? The fleece or the wool become very soft, and they, when they are colored, they obtain the color. And there are bleach and dyes in the tub. Woolen fibers are bleached and then dyed with different colors. Okay, so they are bleached with the chemicals and then they will give the color to the wool. The colored fibers are used to make the yarn. Okay, whatever we have done, the, okay, get the color after bleaching, what we do, we are coloring this with a different color. We are coloring this, and after coloring, what we are doing, we make them into yarn. After coloring, we are making them into the yarn. Okay, yarn is nothing but the thread. Okay, we are making them into the thread. Okay, after making into the thread, these fibers are then combed. So they make them into, okay, they make them into the yarn. Okay, the color fibers are used to make yarn. These fibers, again, okay, these fibers, before that, or before making the yarn, what they do means, after coloring, they comb this. They comb the fibers. They comb the fibers. Okay, whatever the wool or the fleece are there, they comb it. Why they are comb it? Not to be zipped. Okay. There is a machine. See here. You can see this. They are combing here. This is a machine for combing or carding wool. Wool is pulled through many teeth of combing machine. So they are these fibers. Whatever these fibers, they pass these fibers through the comb. Through the comb. This is known as the combing or carding, we can say. We call it as comb. We are separating this long hairs and the short hairs through the combing. Combing or carding. Okay, first we have the, what is the first step? Shearing. Okay, shearing is to remove the wool from the body of the animal by using the razor. It is known as the shearing. After that, we have the scoring. So in the scoring, we are removing all the dirt particles from the fleece or the fur or the hair of the animal. Is known as the scoring. After that, what we are doing? We are doing the sorting. Sorting is nothing but the, we are separating the hair into different groups, like long hair, short hair, soft hair, or the rough hair. We are sorting them. We are sorting them. So we are keeping in a different groups. And then after that, what we take? We have bleach. We have bleached the wool. Why we are bleaching this? Okay, after bleaching, by using the chemicals, we are making the wool to acquire the color. By bleaching only, we can get the color to this wool. Okay, after bleaching, we are doing the coloring. That is dyeing we are doing. Dyeing is coloring. Okay, what we are doing? We are doing the dyeing. Okay, dyeing is nothing but the coloring. Coloring we are doing. After coloring, what we are doing after that, we are combing the, whatever we are getting the wool, after color, we are combing the fleece or the wool. Okay. By using the machine. From there, a machine rolls and pulls and it out in a thick rope, and still another pulls that waste into the long thread. So this, see here, they gives like that, see here, page number, this figure 13, they make into the thread. After comb, what they do, they make them into the thick rope. They make into the thick rope. Okay, they make them into the thick rope. This process is called as spinning. When they make into the rope or the thread-like structure, this is known as spinning. Spinning. Thus we get the yarn which we dyed before weaving. Okay, then after that spinning, we are getting the thread-like structure which is used, or which is used for the making of sweaters or like that. Grandpa, how can I use these needles? So it is not the knitting, we call it as after weaving. It is, okay, see here. It is knitting or weaving. We call it as knitting and weaving. After knitting and weaving, to make the sweaters, we do it. Okay, one like this. One, Okay, from the bottom and from the sides, horizontal and vertically they are weave the cloth. By using knots with loops and rings of long thread of yarn, woolen fibers are knitted. In addition to handmade process of knitting, handlooms and pawlooms are also used on the. Okay, in this also, in this process also, what we are using? We are using by hand. Okay, by handloom, by using the hand also we are making the weaving the woolen clothes, and also by using the power looms also by machines we are able to do the weaving method. Which woolen yarn is woven to fiber? After weaving the cloth, what they do? They make into the sweaters, mufflers, or the gloves, etc. They make them. Woolen threads are stretched from the top of the loom. So see here. From the top of the woolen cloth, okay, woolen thread, they are stretched from the top, and these are called wrap threads, okay, which are from the top. These threads are nothing but wrap threads. It is known as the wrap thread from the top. Okay, the thread that goes side to side are called weft thread. Okay, which goes from side to side. Okay, when they go side to side, this thread is nothing but the weft thread. Weft thread. Okay, which is from the top. This thread is known nothing but the wrap thread, and the thread which goes side to side, this thread is nothing but the weft thread. A shuttle like a big needle takes the weft thread over and under the wrap thread. Okay, they take. From the top they take side to side, so one needle will be passed over this wrap thread. Okay, one more important part of the loom is the harness. The harness lifts every other wrap thread so that the web thread go over. So one more thread will be there, that is harness. Okay, this thread, what they do, they will lift the wrap thread, and then when they lift the wrap thread, the web thread will be go inside the side to side. Under the neck, all types of yarn, whether cotton, silk or wool, they are woven in this manner. Whatever we are weaving, the wrap thread, web thread and the harness thread, all these are present in the. So when they are weaving, they contain the wrap thread, web thread also. In the silk or in the wool or whatever the jute, everything they have the same process will be done. The weaving or whatever the things they are doing, they have to do in the same manner. Neelima was surprised to see how fast knitting was being carried out. Knitting. Knitting, it is called knitting. నేను నిన్న ఇది సెవెంత్ బాయ్స్ ది పేరు రాసుకోవడానికి ఓకే సీయా. సో దిస్ ఇస్ ద హౌ వి ఆర్ ఏబుల్ టు గెట్ ద ఫ్రమ్ ఫైబర్ టు ఓలన్ ఫైబర్ టు ఫైబ్రిక్. So what are the flowchart? What is the flowchart now? Okay, first we are doing the shearing. After that, we are doing the scoring. After that, sorting. Then bleaching. Then dyeing. After that, carding or the combing. After that we are spinning the. After that spinning, we are rolling and twisting. Then we are weaving or knitting. Then we are making the woolen fabric. Okay, these are the process we are doing in the woolen cloth. What is the differences between the silk and the
shape?
See, they are given some. silk and cotton. Cotton. Okay, this one is prepared with protein. It is cellulose. After that, they are made. Okay, they are obtained from animals. Okay, they are obtained from animals, and this is obtained from the plants. Okay, plants. And then what is another differences? Then these 2 points. Is enough. Okay. So we have completed our 3rd lesson and read the lesson. Today I will give the answers to these questions. Thank you.